A happy morning to all of you. Guess you are all keeping well. Friends, have you heard about something called as the cockroach theory? If you haven't, then this is how it goes. At a restaurant, a cockroach flew from somewhere and sat on a lady. She freaked out of fear. Her behavior was contagious as the people around also got panicky. She somehow managed to put the cockroach away, but it fell on the person's plate sitting next to her. He too freaked out and began to throw the plates and spoons randomly. As this continued, the waiter of the restaurant came forward to their rescue. In the delay of throwing, the cockroach now fell on the waiter. The waiter stood firm, composed himself, and observed the behavior of the cockroach on his shirt. When he felt confident enough, he grabbed the cockroach and threw it out of the restaurant. Now friends, if we reflect on this incident, could you tell me what caused people to behave the way they did? Was it the cockroach that was responsible? Okay, if so, then why was the waiter not disturbed? In fact, he handled this situation almost near to perfection without creating any chaos. So it is not the cockroach, but the inability of the people to handle the disturbance caused by the cockroach that disturbed them. Friends, many a times we get irritated, frustrated, worried, angry, hurt, insulted, and disturbed, which is absolutely okay. Would you want to reflect on what actually caused this disturbance in you? Just like the cockroach in this incident, the reasons can be many, like when you don't get what you want, or when you are asked to do something you are not really not interested in, or the way people behave or talk can seem inappropriate to you. The reasons can also be situations like a power cut or unstable internet connection or unavailability of something that you think is important to you. The reasons and triggers can be multifolds. How would you want to handle them? How would you choose to deal with it? Would you want to behave or react like those people who freaked out of fear and irritation, which was spontaneous? Or would you want to be like the waiter who also got disturbed but gave himself the time to calm down, settle himself, and respond when he was confident enough? Friends, when you find yourself disturbed the next time, would you want to pause, give time to yourself to think about it, and choose to behave in a way that you think is healthy and appropriate to you? Think about it. Until then, bye from me and see you next week. Take care and have a great day ahead. Bye.